Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. So this tutorial is about foundation engineering. So you can see on your screen that this course is having 6 modules, in which we have already covered 3 modules. You can see till here we have covered. So today we are going to study about unit number 4, that is shallow foundations. So as the syllabus is displayed on your screen, so you can see that. So it is about assumptions and limitations of rigid design analysis, shape bearing pressure, settlement of foundations, design of isolated combined strap footing. So raft foundation, elastic method is there. So IS code practices for design of raft foundation. So this is brief about the syllabus. Let us see the introduction. So you can see over here that, so according to Terzaghi, what is shallow foundation? We will see first. So you can see Terzaghi says that when the depth is equal to or less than the width. So what it means? It means if this is a foundation, so let us think that this is ground level. So this is ground level. So if this depth, so this is a depth of foundation, let us name it as a D, and this is a breadth of the foundation, let us name it as a B. So what Terzaghi says, if you can see here, if depth is equal to or less than width, so what it means, so this depth should be equal to or less than this breadth. So this depth should be less than or equal to breadth. So then and then only it is called as shallow foundation. So I hope you have studied these things in first year, but I have given you the introduction. Now let us study what are the types of shallow foundation. So basically you can see the shallow foundation is having following types. One is simply a footing or spread footing. Next is strap footing. Next is combined footing. And last one is mat or raft footing. So you can see in this figure, all the type of foundation is shown. So you can see in spread footing or simple footing, there are several subtypes, that is, first one stepped, second one regular mat, third one sloping. So these are the various types of spread footing. Now you can see when this spread footing is used. So I will tell you the situation where this spread footing is used. So let us think that a strata which is lying below. What I mean is, let us think that this is a foundation and the strata which is lying below the foundation is so hard, or if it is having higher bearing capacity, or this is one situation, or the load coming from the top structure. Load, let us name this load as a P. So the load which is coming from the top is very less. So in such a cases, the area of the footing which is required is very small. So in that case, we can go for spread footing. Now, when next type in shallow foundation is combined footing. So when we can go for combined footing, let us think that there are two columns which are very near to each other. So what I want to say is, let us think that there are two columns. So let us think that this is a column which is carrying load P1, and this is a column which is carrying load P2. Okay. So this is the surface where our foundation is lying. Now, if these columns are carrying the load P1 and P2, And if we calculate the area required for the footing, for the spread footing according to bearing capacity, so let us think that area required for P1 and area required for P2 is getting overlapped somewhere in between, So in that case, what we do is we will combine these two loads and make a single footing. So that is called as combined footing. Now, when we use this trap footing, you can see on your screen, when we use this trap footing, so we can use this trap footing when a certain column is on the boundary of the site. So you can see that, let us think that this is a boundary of the site. So we won't be able to extend the foundation of this, footing of this particular column beyond our boundary. So to limit that boundary, we are going to place this column on the boundary, and the column which is near to that will be tied with this with a strap beam. So you can see in the center there is a strap beam. So this type of foundation is called as strap foundation. Now, last type is mat foundation. You can see when the number of columns in a building are very near to each other, or else when the number of columns in the building is placed evenly and bearing capacity of the soil which is lying below, this columns are very less. So in that case, what is going to happen? All the individual footings will overlap with each other. So to avoid that, what we will do? We will provide a combined footing which covers all the columns in the site. So this type of foundation is called as mat foundation. Now you may see the next point, that open excavation exploration method is very much suitable for any type of shallow foundation. So we have studied the exploration methods. In unit number 1. So you can see unit number 1 we have studied, in which it entirely covered about the exploration methods. So open exploration method is very much suitable for any type of shallow foundation. So this is the introduction about the shallow foundations. Now let us study the factors to be considered in deciding the location and depth of shallow foundation. So there are various factors which influence the location and depth of shallow foundations. So you can see the various factors which are listed on your screen. So first one is core depth. So core depth is first one. Second one is water table depth. Third one is topsoil. So fourth one is zone of volume change. Fifth one is fault zone. Sixth one is bearing capacity, and as follows. So these are the factors which influences the depth and location of the shallow foundation. So I'll just explain a simple concept here. You can see depth of shallow foundation is depending upon the depth of hard strata which is available below the soil, or which is available below the ground level. So if the hard strata is available to a shallow depth, we can go up to hard strata. We can excavate up to hard strata and we can start constructing the footing from that particular point. So these are the simple points which explain about the depth of shallow foundation. Now, in further classes, we are going to learn about steps for selection of type of foundation. So you have already studied that there are various types of foundation, mainly shallow and deep. In shallow foundations, we have studied the types in